महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरत्विषे गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय कराले कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमः। First of all, my millions of humble obeisances in the lotus feet of my Paramaradha Dev, Om Vishnu Pad Srimad Bhakti Pragyan Kesava Goswami Maharaj. And same thousands of humble obeisances in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. मैं तो ऐसा सोच रहा था कि यहाँ हिंदी समझने वाले लोग होंगे तो मैं हिंदी में ही अच्छी तरह से बोल सकता हूँ। मेरी अंग्रेजी टूटी फूटी हुई लंगड़ी है, उसमें मैं अपने भावों को अच्छी तरह से प्रकाश नहीं कर पाता। हिंदी में खूब अच्छी तरह से, बंगला में और भारतीय भाषाओं में, बंगाली इत्यादि में बहुत अच्छी तरह से बोल सकता। बट आई थिंक दैट देर आर सो मेनी ऑल्सो मेजोरिटी लाइक दैट Our devotees from different parts of America, here and there, Australia, Canada, and here and there. They have assembled here. So, oh, there are so many seats here and there, you can sit. Oh, you can come here. Here, there is so much seat. Oh, so much seat. So, I will have to speak in English. I want to tell that though Dr. Sahib,
Mukesh ji
had introduced me, but yet something I want to tell you, that when I went for this life in 1946, there was so much relation from Swamiji, Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. At that time he was Abhaycharan. But very soon I received from my holy master renounce order, sannyas. And he after me, so I am senior in sannyas. I am Bhakti Vedanta Narayan. And he is Bhakti Vedanta Swamiji, junior. But he is my Shiksha Guru. Because he is a god brother of my Guru. Junior to my god brother, to my Gurudev. They were bosom friends, very friends. So, that Swamiji, Abhaycharan Prabhu, took sannyas from my Gurudev in Mathura, in Keshavji Gaudiya Math. And I was priest. I made his danda, door coffin, clothes. And I taught him how to use these things. Fire sacrifice also. And also everything. And when he came to America, in New Jersey or here and there.
New York.
He always requested me to come and to preach with him. But I was that time engaged in the service of my Holy Master. I always helped him. A bundle of books I sent from New Delhi. So many ditties. Mridanga Kartal. What he needed. Even he was very fond of sweets of Mathura, Peda. And I used to send him also. Oh, 5 kilos, 10 kilos like that. Also you should know that in his last date, when he was going to pass away from this world, he called me from Mathura. I went to Vrindavan. And with weeping, melting heart, he took my hands in his hand. And he told that, oh, you should forgive me for my offenses that I have done to you or my God brothers. I have done something wrong. I told that, no, I have done nothing wrong. Something is done, but it is not so wrong. So, then he told that, I want that, I request you should give my samadhi here with your own hand, because you are perfect in all these things. I want that by your own hand you should do. There were so many his God brothers and his all
disciples.
GBC disciples were there. But he, in front of them, he requested to do. I told, I accept your proposal. I did so. And he requested me that you should kindly help my devotees. I brought them from various countries. They are quite young. I think that I wanted to train them, but I could not train. So please help them. I told, yes, I accept also. I will do. And for this I came. I have not come for money, that so many persons, even Prime Minister comes to fake something in America, but I have not come. I have come from a very high, wealthy India. That if I will give you one drop of that thing, Vedic cultural things, pure bhakti, your life will be successful. And you will be happy forever. It is guaranteed. You have come from, so many come from India for wealth, to collect some money. But I have not come for that. I am very richest Indian. Oh, you know, Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Ved, Upanishad, Puran. The instructions of them are high class of nectar, more than millions times more than nectar. And by that you can be happy. What you are collecting and what you are doing now, you cannot be happy. With guarantee I may say. Never, never you can be happy. And you can realize self. Are you happy? Can you cross old age, coming very soon, your children, where we like, now you have gone to 40, 50, 60, and very soon, old age will come. You cannot control, and death will come. You cannot be happy. So if you will follow the instructions of Gita Bhagavatam, you can be happy. Whole world is now request this. They want to follow and to be happy. No problem if you are in family life even. You should be there. But why you cannot chant Hare Krishna or any name of Krishna or God, Supreme Personality of God? Any name. Oh, even walking, driving, without mala, with mala, loudly, in heart, in mind, even taking bath, after taking bath, no problem at all. And you will be liberated, it is surely. So, I have come here to help the devotees, the disciples of Swamiji. This was my main object. What he wanted to give to this world, the doctrines of Srimad Bhagavatam, Gita, Veda, Upanishad, Sarve Sukhina Bhavantu, all should be happy in this world. Ma Tamasa Jyotir Gamaya. Don't go to
darkness.
Come to light. What is that darkness? Endless chain of birth and death, suffering and sorrow. This is
darkness.
And what is light? To realize soul. To realize super soul. And what is the relation between Supreme Lord and myself? And that is love. Without love, we are nothing. Perhaps you have heard that love is God, God is love. But not what?
Material.
Lust. Not lust. Lust is different from pure love. In this world only lust is there. No love, pure love and affection. So our Veda, Upanishad and all literatures, Vedic literatures, give this instruction. How to be happy in this life and after that life. You are thinking that you are this physical body. But this is like a garment. When it will be rotten, you will have to give up. If you don't like to give up, but forcibly, you will have to give up. Krishna has given this a very beautiful this body only to realize soul and super soul and the relation between Supreme Lord and soul. Not for eating, drinking and be merry like hawks and pigs and dogs. In comparison to these animals, we are like animals, more than animals. Because they cannot fight with bombs and atoms and so many things. But we do. So, Krishna has given mercifully this beautiful form that in this form we can realize super soul. We can hear Gita Bhagavatam, the teachings of high class of devotees, we can. But we have no time at all. Anyhow, only 24, 25, you local devotees have come. But I think that mostly the devotees from other parts have come. Because they have no taste. I think Dr. Sahib and his wife has
advertised
so much. But they have no time at all. They have to come. They have come from India, from Vrindavan, from Ayodhya, from Navadvipa. For them, but they had no time to. I want to go door to door, but it is impossible for me. Oh, to beg that, oh, you should chant Krishna and be happy. But even they have no time to hear. Oh, what can we say? I think that from tomorrow, you should bring all your relatives to here. That, oh, one Swamiji from India, he is calling us, oh, my dear children, my dear sons and daughters, you should come and take something. Don't give anything. We don't want you, what you have. I have only come for giving something and try to collect something for you to be happy for it. This is my object. Suppose a person is very wealthy, more than Mr. Bush, an Indian Atal Bihari Ajpayee, or Mr. Clinton and his wife. It may be so wealthy. Oh, very beautiful, handsome. And he has all the favorable things to be happy in this world. Gallon and gallons of what? Intoxications.
Drugs.
Liquors. Wine. Ocean. Smoking. Meats. That's everything. Oh, very beautiful. 106 stories of buildings. So many things. Golden ornaments, everything you have.